Hi, my name is Jill. This is Survival Road, and we're doing a sort of a road crew catch-up, check-in, communique, chronicles. I'm exploring different C words, as which we want to call this little check-in videos that we do, but it is Friday. I wanted to say hi. I wanted to give you some updates, some decisions, and what's going to be sort of happening from here. I know I keep saying that, but what can I tell you? So we're going to take a quick break with that, a deep breath. And we're going to see you on the other side. So I made some decisions. Part of you know that have been watching a long time. There's been a constant sort of thrashing around with me and my channel, especially for the last year. And so I wanted to just back up, kind of do this last year highlight, and then where I think maybe it's going from here, because it's been a year now. So last July is when, for no reason, after 10 years of being on YouTube, for no reason whatsoever, people started to watch the videos. And so I've talked about that before, but it was a very separate experience in that I was having my own private party with nobody really watching. So I didn't care what I did, and I was throwing ideas around. I was learning to edit, do some other things. And then, last July, out of nowhere, people started watching. And so I moved through the fall, up through Christmas, and it was continuing to grow, continuing to grow. And January and February were pretty good, and then everything took kind of a nosedive in March. And I didn't understand 100% what was going on with that, but I also know that that there was a lot of it had to do with me. You notice I kind of changed topics in March. I made that one video that I lost a lot of subscribers over, and how I've been in a major thrashing around mode ever since then. And most of that thrashing around mode is what I guess I've learned about myself is what I always do in relationships is there's a lot of negotiating that goes on in any relationship. And my takeaway from this process over the last year is there's three of us in this relationship. There's me, there's you, the viewer, and then there's YouTube. And out of those three, the only one who can really change is me. And so, of course, as you know, in any relationship, if you're the one that has to change, there can be some thrashing around or some I want to break up moments. And I don't want to leave this platform, but I haven't found my way to be in this platform. And part of that struggle has been about what's going on with YouTube. And they've done a couple things. One, they're changing things again. One of the things that they're changing is that they're not sending out the videos to subscribers. And now there's three levels that people have to go through to get notification of a new video. And then there's a tiny percentage that are randomly notified. So the example was given that if you have 1 million subscribers, and your last videos didn't perform the way YouTube wanted them to, then they cut that down to about 50,000, which is, less than 10%. And so it's about 5%. And that's what Facebook does. But Facebook only sends your stuff out to about 7% of the people. But just think about that. You say, I want to know what that person is doing. And YouTube or Facebook says, yeah, but we're only going to tell 5% of you what's going on. So we've talked a lot about what's happening with them, where they're moving. It's not towards people like me. It's not towards creators. They are trending towards the conventional market, Hollywood, kind of those people, celebrities, whatever that means, right? Even though that grouping is getting less and less popular, I know. So this isn't me complaining about YouTube. This is, the second piece of that is they've re released a lot of data in the analytics for those of you who do this, know that there's some analytics that come with every video and with your channel. And so they've released some new data, which helps me understand what has happened for most of this year. Unfortunately, the data is only good from January 1st. So I can't see what happened the first half of last year, but I can see what happened January 1st through now, which is sort of when things were going well and then when things crashed. And so one of the biggest things that's happening is right now, since I changed topics generally and stopped producing videos regularly, it's like being a rat in a maze, a behavioral maze. And every time you move in a direction that the scientist doesn't want you to, they zap you to get you back in line. And so for people who are very good at conforming and live within those standards, they are doing really well. People like me who don't, are doing very poorly. And so that's a little bit about what's happening. You know, the second piece of that is that, like I said, there's me, you, and YouTube. The three of us are in a relationship. And the people who are really successful on this platform, what I get, are the people who, all three of you, are really happy with your relationship. People like me who are incongruent, what YouTube wants, what you guys want, and what I want are three radically different things. So this process isn't going well for me in the sense that we are all out of sync. And that's not a right or wrong. That's not a judgment. That's not a complaint. That's not a criticism. That's just information. And like I said, the only one who can change any of that is me. So that's what I've been doing the last 2 months, and it's only been the last 2 weeks that I really, since they released this new data, and I've been listening a lot more to some other experts about this. So I feel pretty clear about what I want to create off of YouTube. I'm still pretty confused about what I want to do on YouTube, but I know I don't want to break up. So, what I really get, though, is I'm starting over, so I'm basically starting from scratch because I have to build a whole new internal profile for the artificial intelligence to acknowledge that I exist and then create a foundation and build from there. So it has actually less to do with you guys than it does with me and my relationship with YouTube's artificial intelligence. Who knew this would be a conversation we'd be having? And so I recognize that, but the problem with that is it's not a forgiving person, it's an automated machine. There's no discussion, there's no there's nothing but the facts. And so it's not a real relationship where you negotiate and evolve. It's like, this is what we do, conform or get out of the way. So if you know anything about me, conforming is not my strength. So that's where I'm at. I'm trying to build a platform within my own mind that I can conform enough that can establish me on this platform and other social media platforms, basically for the next 10 years. So that's really hard for somebody like me because I don't do anything consistently or conform very well. So, all right, so that's the first little check-in thing. The second thing, same thing about our relationship versus me and YouTube, is I don't think I've been telling the right story. And that's something that I'm working on right now about which story I want to tell. What are my goals here? What are my goals with you as a community? And that's the question I'm asking myself. What kind of exchange do I want with my YouTube community people? Because there's two kinds of people that watch. There's the ones that want involved, and then there's ones who just watch and keep going. So there's a couple different kinds of relationships, you know, a creator has with their viewers. So that's something I'm trying to figure out for myself. I don't think I'm telling the story that I want you to hear, because based on what's been happening in the last year, I don't think I've done a very good job. So that is back on me, and that is something I am working with. And the third thing, good news, bad news, is I ran into a friend of mine who's having the same skin cancer issues, and she freaked me out. And so I've made the decision, even though this is healing, I've made the decision to explore and go ahead and do a little more treatment. So it might be like 2 more months before I feel like my face is back to normal. Meaning I have to use this camera with less detail, and I have to back it way up because the beginning process of this is really bad. As you know, I was off camera for a month. And so I'm gonna use this time now, one, because it's pretty aggressive. If I have the kind that's aggressive, I need to deal with it. And so my health is more important, obviously, than YouTube videos. But it means that the documentary process where the official video is getting shot, I need to put that on hold until all this clears up. And which is okay, because I don't have all the funding or all the equipment I need for that anyway. So this is a really good time to transition while I'm trying to start over in the YouTube universe and start new projects. This little break that I took April 30th is going to be extending for a little bit longer. So I still plan on making videos, but right now I'm sinking myself. I'm getting zapped every time I make a video. I'm getting pushed back further down the line. So it's hard because there's not a lot of incentive to make videos. Because every time I do it and I don't have that new baseline, or that I'm not on that new foundation or that new platform, all I'm doing is pushing myself further and further back down the queue. So that's partly what's happening right now. I just wanted to give you an update that all three of us are having relationship issues. And so we have to negotiate a new form of relationship. Unfortunately, the only one I can work with is myself. And you know how that is when it's all about you. There's no hurry to do that. But I really need to just do it once because of what YouTube is doing. It's not something I can continuously keep starting over with, because every time I do that, I'm making it worse for myself. So it isn't that I want to make a living on YouTube, but the videos here are a really good way to get the message out, to get find people who are interested in your message. But they're also a really good testing ground for different kinds of messages. So that's really my goal with all this. Like I said, I just wanted to give you an update about where we're at with our little process here, and say thank you to those of you who are really hanging in there. But right now, me and YouTube are kind of at odds with each other. And so all these videos are doing is pushing me further and further back. So I'll keep making them a little bit at a time till I'm ready to really roll out this foundation. So before we go, we're going to take one more deep breath for the road, as I hope you'll rise with the sun in your eyes, love in your heart, feet firmly on the ground, as we're walking on survival road, one step at a time, so that you stay human, live free, and die wild. And with that, I'll see you next time.